Hello, somebody. So good to be back with you. I'm going solo right now. We have had some wonderful, wonderful interviews. It has been absolutely amazing to have some of my closest friends help Hello Somebody jump off. So, Michael Render, aka Killer Mike.
Hello, somebody.
Sister girlfriends, Susan Sarandon.
Hello, somebody.
And Mayor Carmen Yulín Cruz.
Y estamos escuchando a Hello Somebody, que en español es
Hola. My God. And then to have Philip Agnew. I finally call him Dr. Agnew.
Hello, somebody.
I mean, we have really just had some very amazing folks grace Hello Somebody so far. And there's many more people to come. We're going to get people from all walks of life, not just the well-known folks that I just named, but we're going to get some everyday folks on this podcast. This is our podcast. And I want you to know, we're going to walk this journey together. Last week, we put out a question to our Patreon members, wanted to know about what they wanted to hear from me in some solo sessions. And so I did pick one for this week to highlight, and shout out to Alexandra Snyder. She said the following: "You are an inspiration and a motivator. What gives you hope right now? And where do you find your joy? We love you." And then she put in paren, "In a future more just world, Madam President." Well, Alexandra, I am smiling from ear to ear right now. Thank you so much for this wonderful question, asking me where do I find my joy. And thank you for believing in my leadership and calling me Madam President. That has a nice little ring to it. Where do I find my joy? Multiple places. And at times it's hard. You do have to seek joy and embrace it, like hold on to it and don't let it go. But in a practical way, I do meditate every morning. Between 5 minutes and 30 minutes in the morning. It is my routine. And so I have found that in meditation, doing that as soon as I wake up, that really helps me to center my day. I totally recommend it. There's some good apps out there that can help guide you through meditation, some good books out there about meditation. And because we have the access to the web, I mean the entire the world is the classroom now, so you can look up some best techniques for meditation. But I would say early in the morning or right before you go to bed, those are two perfect times, even though you can certainly do it in the middle of the day. But when you're fresh and you first get up, center your mind. So I meditate. That helps out a lot. Exercise, even though I must confess I have fallen off. Rona round is real, baby. I mean, it's been harder and harder to separate workspace from home space, and you get bored and you start to eat and eat and eat. And I'm telling y'all, the cookie monster has been on me. The not cookies in a sense, but sugar. So damn addicting. So I got to pull myself back together. But yes, exercise. I exercise at least 5 times a week. And, you know, anything from, you know, lifting weights to the treadmill, to the elliptical, to the rower, to boxing. Oh, my God. I love to box. Let me tell you something. Boxing is a stress reliever. Not only cardiovascular and just, you know, the rhythm that it takes to box, but you can picture some folks' faces on that boxing bag. And there is no therapy like putting somebody's face on that boxing bag, a good way to relieve that stress and visualize some stuff. You know where I'm coming from, but I absolutely love boxing. Another way that I find some joy is in hula hooping. A lot of folks don't know it. I can hula hoop my ass off. I'm good at it. So I love hula hooping. I have a weighted hula hoop, and that is very therapeutic as well. I'm cracking up to myself as I think about me hula hooping, but that is a lot of fun. It's different, so try it. in many ways kind of like meditation and like boxing, but different. It's more relaxing. It has a rhythm to it, you know, and it causes you to center yourself. So I certainly recommend the hula hoop. Something that I have recently taken up in the exercise room is jump rope. Love it. Jesus. But it's very, you know, it's intense. You know, it's not a low impact. It's not a low impact workout. So if you can jump rope, baby, ain't nothing like jumping rope. You thinking you in shape. If you try jumping rope with a weighted jump rope, that will let you know where you stand really quickly. So yes, exercise, Pilates, love, 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 love Pilates. Trying to do a little yoga. It's kind of hard for me to get into it. I know yoga is definitely has that body and mind connection. Whatever you do, exercise, find something that brings you joy, but it challenges you. But you gotta move your body because that helps with your mind. That helps the mind, the body, and the soul. Working out has an impact on everything that you do. Another way that I find joy is certainly with my family. Really blessed to have a family that loves me and lifts me. And certainly we go through what all families go through, but you know, love is the foundation. So that, and I have a new grandbaby. I'm a yaya or grandma, even though my brother says stop tripping. But yes, and oh my God, that little boy, I call him my special advisor. Some on my team call him the minister of cuteness. He is cute, but I don't want him to get too caught up in that, because cuteness without substance, baby, means absolutely nothing. So I call him my special advisor. But he certainly brings me lots of joy. And just when I thought I couldn't have another level of love, you know, you love your children deeply, those of us who have children, and even people who love other people's children or love children in general, that is a deep love. And as a parent, it doesn't matter how old they get, you will always be mama. I let my son know, you ain't never going to be older, you know, growner. Not a word. You're never going to be growner than I am. And but no, being a mom is a gift. And so being a grandmother, to have a grandson, ooh, that is a whole nother level of love right there. One that I never thought I could have, but just really cementing for me even more. You know, if you think I'm kicking ass right now, I will be kicking a whole lot more ass to make this world a better place for my little baby, my little grandbaby. I mean, we're always on the go. We never take time. And Alexandria, stillness. You know, we never take the time to be still enough. We're always on the go. We're either on social media. We have our phones. The phone is always buzzing. Just, we're always in a constant state of go, go, go. And I have found, not just when I'm meditating, but just taking a moment to be still for a moment is very helpful. You know, I had the opportunity recently to be on a Zoom call with some Bernie delegates from the great states of Arizona, Washington, and Oregon. And one of the ways I started the call, and I'm sure that I've really surprised them with this, but I said, we're going to take a moment of silence for 60 seconds. We are going to be still. And you can imagine that 60 seconds seemed a lot longer than it really was. And before we took that moment of silence or that moment of stillness, I said to them that we have to have the courage, take the time to embrace our emotions, to be still, and that it is okay. Although some folks want to pretend that it's not okay. It is okay to be in tune with your feelings. It is okay to get angry. It is okay to be sad. It is okay to be happy. It is okay to have righteous indignation. It is okay to be disappointed. It is okay to experience the entire gamut of emotions as a thinking human being. It's okay. So let's be still and embrace the very emotions that you are feeling right now in this moment. And I'm telling you, it was something. That 60 seconds seemed to have lasted for 5 minutes because you're forcing people to do something that they probably don't ordinarily do, and especially in a group. And because that particular call was political in nature, the emotions that I wanted them to focus in on was disappointment. Because I know many people on that call, the Bernie-crats, are disappointed, and the progressives feel put upon and told what to do and how to think and how to feel, and, you know, all of the foolishness that swirls in the political environment these days. I wanted them to be still and embrace those emotions. So on a different level, those of us who are together right now, for us to take a moment to be still, we won't do it for 60 seconds, but to be still for a moment and embrace whatever feelings you are feeling in this moment. Let's do that just for a little while. Stillness for a little while. I mean, that's hard to do. That was almost 30 seconds, but it felt much longer than that. And so one way to find joy is just to center yourself. You have to do that. We have to do that. Because in order to be a blessing to somebody else, in order to help somebody else, you got to be able to be healthy in your mind, in your body, in your soul, in your spirit. You know, when you get on the airplane, although many of us are not flying these days because of COVID, but those of us who have flown, I certainly will not assume that everyone that is listening today has been on an airplane, but you know what they tell you to do is, before you can help somebody else in moments of turbulence, you know, should the airbag drop, place the mask on yourself and then help the person next to you. Why? Because you got to save yourself to be able to save somebody else. I definitely find joy in the rain. I love, love, love a good thunderstorm. The overcast skies and the lightning streaking and the rain pouring down. It gives you an opportunity to think. You know, when I was growing up, my grandmother would not allow us to move. We could not move if there was a thunderstorm. She would make us turn off all the TVs in the house, and we had to be still and quiet. And as the thunder roared and the lightning struck, my grandmother would say, "That's God doing his business." Oh my God, every thunderstorm that I am blessed to see, to feel, I always think of my grandmother. And, you know, growing up and being told to be still was not what you wanted to do. But as I reflect on that, my grandmother, she knew. I don't know if she knew she was an expert in most things, but in that, yeah, be still. She could have been a stillness, a what do they call that? A mindfulness expert. My grandmother was a mindfulness expert before that became cool. But be still, God is doing his business, she would say. Where do I find my joy? Music? Oh my God, I love, love, love good music. And you know, my grandmother, who many of you know through my Three Bones story, her Three Bones story that I have certainly made a national story. People, I am known for telling that story, and it doesn't matter how many times people hear it, they want to hear it over and over and over again. And I just really wish my grandmother was around to know how famous her three bone story has become. But the wishbone, the jawbone, and the backbone. And the wishbone is for hoping and praying. The jawbone is for speaking your truth, baby. Speaking truth to power when necessary. But just, you know, lifting your voice. And the backbone, the most important bone of them all, is the bone that keeps you standing. When all is coming against you, you got to stand anyhow. That's my grandmother's three bones. And I bring up my grandmother because, in relation to music, because she would play some of the best music. And I am so grateful that I was introduced to Sam Cooke by my grandmother. When I say introduced, not physically introduced, but introduced to his music. One of my favorite songs, A Change Gonna Come.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
I played that song a lot. That was my theme song when I was running for Secretary of State in the great state of Ohio in 2014 against the Secretary of Suppression. That's what I call this man, but I digress. Let's not let that steal our joy. But yes, that was my song, A Change Is Gonna Come. Sam Cooke.
Beyond the sky, it's been a long.
A singer by the name of Brooke Benton. Love, love, loved him. My mom loved Minnie Riperton.
La 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 la.
You know, in that house, introduced to the OJs. Oh my God, to Patti LaBelle. To Luther Vandross.
But gloom, but all the
woo, baby, music.
Mother, there's too many of you.
Oh my God, Marvin Gaye, I mean, you name it.
Brother, 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 there's far too many.
Music, so definitely music brings me joy too. I think my spirit animal though in music is Fantasia.
I put your picture on my mirror. Start to blush when somebody says your name. In my stomach there's a pain.
Lord have mercy. I think Fantasia sings like I speak. That is my spirit animal when it comes to music. And I have an alarm set to Fantasia. Yes, every morning. I got several alarms set, but Fantasia is one of my alarms. I just absolutely adore her and her spirit. So music can bring you joy too. You gotta find those things, whatever it is. I work out to LL Cool J.
Push it out, girl, arch your back. Them 17s is fitting like bubble wrap. Plus they low on your hips.
That's my workout guy right there. Running that treadmill with LL Cool J. So I have a whole playlist of LL Cool J. And then with Beyonce, Girls Run the World. Hello, somebody. Every girl needs to have that song on their playlist. You better talk about that. And absolutely love Nina Simone. I was named after Nina Simone. My mother loved her a lot as well. And so Nina Simone, baby. You talk about telling the truth through music. That is what Miss Nina did. Yes, she did that. Hello, somebody. Yeah, I got to pop my fingers to that. That love Nina Simone so very much. Al Green.
Love and happiness. But wait a minute, something's going.
I mean, I'm certainly not naming all. This is not exhaustive by any stretch of the imagination. But to answer the question, what brings me joy? Good music. I certainly love me some Lauryn Hill.
3 weeks since you were looking for your friend, the one you let hit it and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? Yeah. You act like you and him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy.
Hello, somebody. Music soul child.
Love. So many people.
Love him. Yeah, I mean, it's a lot. I try to play Nina Simone's Feeling Good and Here Comes the Sun at least 4 or 5 times a week.
Little darling, here comes the sun, I say, it's all right.
Feeling Good is a good song. Both of those, Here Comes the Sun and Feeling Good, really good to wake up to.
It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony.
Major, Why I Love You is beautiful too.
This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh.
To love one another.
One of my oldie but goodies, Jesus is Love by the Commodores.
In their hearts, 'cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down.
Lord have mercy. Lionel Richie, he did that in that song. Yes, he did.
And I know.
So yeah, joy. How do I find my joy? Meditation, exercise, family, stillness, and music. Another way, though, that I find my joy is being actively engaged and to use the strength and the talents and the gifts that the Creator has given me to make this world a better place. To be able to stand up and speak a truth, even though it is exhausting at times, that right there, that gives me joy too. It's a different kind of joy. And to be seen as the people's champion brings me lots of joy. And Alexander, thank you for that question, because we don't often pause to think about what brings us joy. I would like to hear from some other folks. Let us hear from you, hello somebody. Let us know what brings you joy and what recommendations you have for people to try to get that joy. You got to grab on to it, baby. It can be elusive. It's not just going to present itself. You have to make it so. You have to get yourself in a mindset that says, today, baby, I will have my joy. Today, I will find my joy. Because there are so many things that happen in this life that tries to steal your joy. But don't let it happen on a regular basis. And it's not about looking through rose-colored glasses. It's not about having a smile on your face all day, every day. But at some point over the course of a day or the course of a week or course of a month, if you have not done something that brings you joy, you got to rethink that thing. Because life should be joyous. Now, we do know for a lot of people it's harder to find joy. It is. Because people are suffering, no doubt about it, and we cannot ignore those things. In order to be a help to somebody else, you got to be healthy, again, mind, body, soul, and spirit. So try to seize joy wherever you can find it, because it is certain that the world will try to take it from you. Where do you find your joy? I want to know. Yes, I want to know, where do you find your joy? So please share with us at Hello Somebody. Hello Somebody, share with us how you find your joy. I want to end with, well, no, we're not going to end. It's just going to see until next time, I should say, until next time. I want to encourage you to not get weary in well-doing. Encourage you to take time for self-care, even if it's just 5 minutes a day. Set aside that 5 minutes. I hope you give yourself more than 5 minutes, but set aside at least 5 minutes a day for you. Center yourself. Do something, do one thing or a few things that make you smile from ear to ear, that brings you joy. Joy is indeed a beautiful thing, and you deserve to have joy. You can do it, but you got to work at it. You have to put the effort in to have that joy. Once you find it, hold on to it and do not let it go. Hello, somebody.